Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to the SM Cathedral One Poll Guide. I just recorded this on the cuff, so this is going to be a quick video, just a little overall guide on how to do this single poll. Obviously, there's one guy or two guys, whoever, right at the start, there's a guy that you have to kill that always gets aggroed by the guys that you're bringing in here to boost, so you don't count that guy. You kill that guy standing right there by the door. So you start off with rank one arcane explosion pull right there. Then you just kind of body pull these guys, hit them with the Frost Nova, and the next thing you're going to want to do is just avoid any and all contacts with the mobs all the way up until the boss door. Now, in this video, the boss door is actually already open. I failed my first attempt before this, just caught a bad slow. You're going to see the slow that I'm talking about later on and how to avoid it as well. If you don't have escape artist or any sort of PvP trinket or anything, this slow can be a real pain in the ass. It can really screw you. It's not that common, especially if you're spec'd into spell absorption, but you know that we'll cross that road when we get there. There is a way to get out of it, but you need the cold snap to be active. So you CS the boss there. Get a nice quick Nova on those mobs and blink past these ones that are chasing you from the first room. Next thing you want to do is just kind of arcane explosion rank one, of course, to conserve as much mana as you can. Hop all the way around and aggro as many of these mobs as you can, using your blink pretty liberally, but also remembering to save it for key times, and that's coming up here. So here I use the blink just to kind of get that little bit of extra distance, but when I come up around the corner here, like, I'm going to take this left up here, run along that whole wall, and then when it's time to come back towards the other set of stairs, that's the point in time where the blink is absolutely crucial for you to have. It's not always 100% necessary, but it's a pretty safe bet that you're going to need to use it, or you'll get a nice little bit of wiggle room. So use it right here at the end of that hallway, just to get extra distance between you and those patrols right behind you, or the mob behind you, I should say. So then straight up the stairs in here, we're going to find the only safe spot that we're going to be using here in this pull, the very end rafter, the very end between the two rafters. You jump up there and you can reapply your shields, you can evocate, you can activate fire ward if you want to do all that jazz, and everything behind you, you can't see it in the video, but everything has just stopped moving. They will not attack you. All right, so then keep pulling, and this part's very important. Make sure you go up this right side of the staircase. Do not jet right back down. If you jet back down, they follow you too closely and they catch you before the bottom of the stairs. So as you can see, they all run behind you and file in, and that's the slow I'm talking about. 15 second slow, you need an ice block macro. You need to be in and out of that ice block and then use the cold snap to get the ice block right here. Okay, so wait for all of these things to aggro on you right there at the bottom of the stairs, and then you're going to hop up onto the ledge right in front of you. This is your sweet spot. There's three fish-shaped statues. You want to kind of camp right at the second one, and then just take this damage from the boss and anything that might have resisted the stun, and make sure you get this pack nice and neat on this cement walkway before you jump off, because you kind of want them to all be bunched up. You don't want them to be straggling. You want to make sure you keep them frozen the whole time. Okay, and that the boss obviously is not going to be getting as slowed. He's much, much faster. You just kind of have to take the hits and keep your shields up. Don't try and get a mana shield and an ice barrier up at the same time between blizzard cooldowns. You'll probably screw it up. So basically just jump, do one shield, blizzard. Then if you need another shield, jump, do the other shield, blizzard. Just make sure you're keeping your shields up, because the boss will hit you pretty hard if you don't have those shields available to you. But other than that, it's just rinse and repeat. I mean, the casters are never going to hit you. The casters are never going to hit you. You're going to absorb everything. You'll have unlimited mana. And then after you get all the mobs down, it's just cleanup work. There's nothing to it, guys. And at the end of the video, I will show you my gear on this mage. It's not impressive. It's not impressive. There's a good amount of, like, pre-raid bis gear, but I still have some greens. I think my best item is a pair of boots from Blackwing Lair. There's really nothing special to it, and you can sell these runs. I think the going rate on Pagle right now is 60 gold. You get 5 runs SM, 5 runs Armory. Both instances can be solo pulled, the whole entire thing, just very, very quickly. So then you just use, you know, you want to keep the casters up until last, obviously, because they're fueling you mana. But at this point, guys, the pull's done. You've already done all the hard work. Everyone's already looting the shit. And that's pretty much it. I mean, it's going to take a few practice runs. Any sort of dungeon boosting where you're doing the whole dungeon in one pull, there's a lot of finesse to it. It's all about the practice that you put into it, and that's, you know, that's what's going to make you better. It's much more dependent on how used to the run you are and how well you can go through the steps without making mistakes, rather than the gear you have. But here's the gear that I have on this mage. just that elemental staff, banshee finger. You know, I'm not going to read every single one, but guys, this is not good gear. this is a very under-geared mage. And that went pretty smoothly. It went pretty smoothly. So, I mean, if you do five of these runs, it's not crazy to say that you might make a mistake and then you die. But if you stay at it, you go in there, you get some good practice runs in, maybe bring some lobies with you while you practice, you're going to get this and you're going to be selling these for lots and lots of money in no time. But that is all we have for you today. Thank you for tuning in. Remember to like, subscribe, follow, hit me on twitch.tv/bigpasta92. We go live every day, Monday through Friday, usually by 9 p.m. Eastern time, and also at bigpasta92 on Twitter. Thanks, guys. Bye.